V8, multiplying positive and negative numbers and then collecting like terms. So here we have all multiplication right here, the parentheses, and so we're going to multiply 1 times 2, which is 2, and then 2 times 3, which is 6. The number of negatives that we're multiplying by are 3, 1, 2, 3 negatives. If you multiply by 3 negatives, your final answer will be negative. This is a positive and a 10, so we're going to bring those down, so positive and a 10. Now these are different signs. Different signs will subtract, so 10 from 6 leaves 4. The bigger sign always wins. The 10 is the bigger number, so the bigger sign will be the positive. So this will be a positive 4, so I'll leave it understood positive. Okay. Furthermore, what we have is, and that's not a negative there, it's actually a positive there. I didn't mean to write that. But anyway, so 1 times 4 is 4, and 4 times 5 is 20. So this will be 20. And what we have is 2 negatives. Now, 2 negatives, as you remember, when you multiply by 2 negatives, you're going to get positive or a blank. So this will be a positive 20. We're going to bring down the plus and the 11. And these are same signs. Now, same signs we'll add. So we'll add these and get 31. The bigger sign is going to win. The 20 is the bigger sign, and it is positive. So therefore, the 31 will be positive. Next, we have multiplication of 1 times 3, which is 3, and 3 times 4, which is 12. Okay. Now, this is a total of 3 negatives. 3 negatives multiply gives you a negative. Here, we have a combination of a positive and a negative. Remember, the combinations of positive negatives here will give you a negative. I'm sorry. Positive negatives will give you a negative. So this combination right here will be a negative and then the 12. These are same signs. Same signs will add. We'll get 24. The bigger sign wins. And so they're both the same size. We can take either one. So let's take this negative and say this is negative 24. Next, we have 1 times 2 is 2, and then 2 times 3 is 6. We have a total of 1, 2, 3, 4 negatives that we're multiplying. If you multiply 4 negatives together, your final answer will be positive. Here we have a positive and a negative together. These will combine to become 1 negative. And then 13. Okay, these are different signs. Positive 6 and negative 13, so we're going to subtract these. So 6 from 13 leaves us 7. Now the bigger sign is the 13, so this is going to be a negative 7. Using the sign of the 13, which wins. Here we have 1 times 3, which is 3, and 3 times 4, which is 12. These are 1, 2, 3 negatives. When you multiply 3 negatives, you will get a negative answer. Here we have a double negative, or 2 negatives. And remember, with 2 negatives, that's going to be a positive or blank, but we're going to use the positive this time. So this will be a positive and a 14. Okay, these are different signs, 12 and 14, so we're going to subtract those and get a 2. The bigger sign comes from the 14, which is a positive, so this will be a positive 2. So we'll leave it blank. Okay, next, we have a multiplying 1 times 3 is 3, and 3 times 4 is 12, so this is 12. Now we have 1, 2, 3 negatives multiplying. When you multiply by 3 negatives, you will get a negative. This is just a single negative and a positive 15. So when you combine a negative and a positive, you get a negative. So this is negative 15. These are same signs. Same signs will add, so we'll get a 27. And remember, the bigger sign wins, which will be the 15's negative. So this final answer will be negative 27.